Hello guys, welcome to another video tutorial. Today I'll be teaching you how to use the image batch processing tool in Adobe Photoshop. So let's get started. I have gathered up some sample photos here. There are 9 photos. So what we do is, suppose we need to make all these photos black and white. So first I'll show you how to make one photo black and white. Let's get started by opening up your Photoshop. Here I have my Photoshop open. Now navigate to the folder where you have your store your photos, and just drag that photo inside your Photoshop canvas like this. Once you have your image opened up, first thing you need to do is create and record actions. To record the actions, you need to open up the actions menu. You come up to the window menu on top and open this actions tab, and it will open the actions tab here. And what you need to do is create a new action. What will happen once you do is, Photoshop will start recording whatever steps you do after you have started, and hit this create new action button. First just create a new action and name it. I'll just name it black and white, and hit record. Once you hit record, it starts recording whatever steps you do or whatever effects you apply to the photo. So once I have hit the record button, it will start recording. As you can see, the red button is enabled here. It's pressed down in the actions menu. So now come up to the image menu on top, come up to the adjustments menu and select this black and white option. What it does is, it's make the photo simple black and white, and just hit OK, and then save this photo somewhere else on the desktop. I'll come to the file menu here on top, save as, and I'll create a new folder on the desktop here. I'll call it black and white photo and hit save. I'll choose the format as JPEG. That's the general format usually used. Once that's done, just hit save, and it will ask the JPEG quality option. I'll hit it to maximum as it is and just hit OK, and you can just close the photo once you're done. After you're done with this step, you can just click on the stop button, which will stop recording the actions. And now it has saved whatever steps you did just now. Now to repeat this step to each photo, if you have like multiple 10-20 photos, it will be difficult. So that's when the image batch processor is used. To apply that, come up to the file menu on top, come up to the scripts menu here, and click on image processor. And now you need to select the folder where you have stored your images. I'll come to the desktop and I have saved them here in the sample photos, and I will just hit open. There are 9 photos inside this folder, as you can see. Just hit open. Then you have to select the second folder. Once you have selected the folder, just navigate to the folder where you want to save the photo. I'll save it by coming up to the desktop and clicking on black and white photos and hit open. And all the way at the bottom, you have this run actions tab. Just checkbox, just check this. And you need to select the actions which we had created, which is called black and white. I had named it, so it's easy for us to remember. Once we have that done, once you hit run, it will start converting all the photos to black and white, and it will save them all with into that folder where you have selected here. Just hit run and just see how it. So once that's done, you can navigate to the desktop folder and let's see if it has made them all black and white. Here is the folder where I told it to save. As you can see, we have now all the 9 images black and white. So I hope you have learned, guys, with this tutorial something, and you can feel free to ask me any questions if you have. Thanks for watching.